Good evening. This dream started back in August with this group, where we met at Perkins one day to discuss ideas of where this future drama club will be. And tonight, they will present to you an original production of A Cut Above the Rest. It is entirely done by the students and the directors. Please, during the show, please turn off your cell phone. We have use of a strobe light. If you have problems with the strobe light, please let us know. Also, please remain quiet during the scenes. Since August, this group has come together and has put together one of the finest shows in the area. Tonight, I hope you enjoy it. Let's go back to sleep.
Thank you. This is what I do. I wait on people. I listen. No real voice, no real person. I'm a watcher in life. Never fully taking part, but never fully away. Sometimes I reply memories in the third person, away from it all. People do it all the time. It's called visualization. I visualize the situation, understand it, then write it in my journal. I feel the journal knows more about me than I do. My friends never write, so I write things down they say. Sometimes, I pretend they're my own. It's not stealing. I feel they would want me to use their words. Do you ever find yourself talking to yourself? If you're mumbling now, you know the answer. It's perfectly normal, but people look at me so strangely. Sometimes, I let myself be someone I'm not. You may not think I hear you. You may not think I listen to you. But your words cut deeper than you know.
Ma'am, would you like some more coffee? Maybe a scone? Shakespearean friends, hence the hot coffee cometh.
Dude, Shakespeare sucks. And how about that test today? Plus, the teacher just told her, I mean, come on, does he think that sweater vest is cool or something? And what was he talking about in class today anyway? Sleeping? Drinks? I don't get it.
To sleep, perchance to dream. You need to lose thyself in thine own world, noble friend. Sweater vest king.
How are you so funny? I would be afraid of some of the stunts that you pull. I watch you in class and some of the remarks you make. How do you do it? How do you turn it on and off? I mean, sometimes you were really funny and then, well, other times you're so shy and so withdrawn. And what about that journal of yours? What do you write about in there?
My friend, question not what you may perceive, just accept as is.
Bill. Bill. Check. 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 Bill. Check.
Thank you.
and you mope around the next minute being belligerent to people. Then you quiet up again. I hate to tell you this, but sometimes you scare the customers. Get your head together and focus on your job.
I find it hard.
You shouldn't have to carry that burden yourself. That's my job. See, to give people presents. Everyone has that person in their life. Who's yours?
I don't know anymore.
Hey, can you get those tables over there? I hate waiting on them. They're so creepy.
Looking into the past, were we? What a cute picture. Us back then. What happened to our smiles? You used to be so graceful and perfect. Why did we have to quit ballet? It used to be so much fun. Until... I still dance sometimes. When I'm alone, it sometimes takes it away. Hey, maybe we could do a little dance. Anyone. Broadway. Play something.
Judge people from far away and lie.
What's your deal anyway?
I just like to look at people. Notice what they give off.
Well, here's what I notice. You come in here every day and order the same thing. Straight black coffee. Yet you never say a word. What's different today?
I don't know what's different. I just feel something about it. Take that girl over there. She doesn't come here for coffee or books. She comes here for attention.
How can you tell that just by looking at her?
Because she's been reading the same book for the past 2 weeks and has returned to age. It's a romance novel. She's been eating, she has an excuse to cry and have some choice of companionship. I think she was hurt by someone she loves. She wears a ring with a heart on it. Every day she just comes in and looks at me for a minute while the tears well up in her eyes, right before she opens the door.
Well, if you know all that about her, why didn't you send anything to her or try to help her?
Because whatever it is she's looking for, she's not going to find it by wearing a mask like that and pretending to be something she's not.
Do someone else.
Sure,
oh, come on, it can't be
extremely intelligent girl. But your light is clouded. You wear a fake smile on your face that says I'm fine. But really, you're screaming inside. You're only friends of those who hurt. Your journal is your only way to release your confusion, depression, and anger. But you rely on everyone. When it fails, so will you. Saddest part of it all is, you don't know anyone or any way out.
No, that's not true.
You talking to me? Is that even you?
Sometimes I wonder, are you my bad dream or am I yours? Think about it. What are we to each other? What's real? Are you real? Are your feelings real? Or are you just another person pulling your strings?
You know I'm real. What I say is real. I really don't think you're here when I talk to you sometimes. You forget a lot of what I say. And I'm curious. That dream, what's in it?
A lot. I kind of just let him know. No, I just get so stressed out. So much goes on inside a day. I watch my friends. They help me through it.
Your friends? They're not your friends. How do you not see them? They're hope. They're fake. You have to see through it.
They stand up for me.
Yes, what are you talking about?
What's wrong? Do you want me to make him go away? No, don't talk to
me. This is messed up. We're sitting here trying to have a conversation. You get spaced out, saying you're leaving or shut up. You seem to want to talk. They turn into seconds to something I don't know. I don't know what I see in you. You're so difficult. I can't even begin to understand you.
Get away from me, you freak. You're not beautiful, and I won't be like you. Then stay away from me.
Oh, you live in there.
Do not just see
I
that.
I don't care. It's us I care about.
My problem. Caring for us.
So it is, just like you said it would be. The life goes easy on me. Most of the time. Thank you. different pages, the hero finds herself at a crossroads. If you want Frank the Happy Rabbit to save the chicken from the car, turn to page 34, or some other cliche happy ending. Sometimes I wish my life could have the options put out in front of me. Jump to another excuse not to feel loved, or turn to page 120 to turn off the pain. I know I would just look at the end of the page and stare. I wouldn't choose. Just look at the end of the page. Choiceless.
Our friend has a problem. The vision's in the past tense. I know she really doesn't love me, but she can't cut free. Her life's played out minutes after it already happened. Does she realize her future's just a replayed past? Why can't she let go? We did. We moved on. She still can't move on. She still replays the broken down love scene. A past with no future. Because it hurts her now. Mechanical movements of a hollow soul. He was just someone to hold on to. She let herself fall too hard. He isn't the right one for her, but she still hurts.
Someone to hold on to? She wanna change the past? You can't change the past.
Only in her dreams.
He's such a liar. I want to make him pay.
This is what's in my mind. But I don't.
Let's go!
you write about in your precious journal? Do I fill up the pages of your life? You know, it's a pity you never saw you were being used. But if you think you can embarrass me in this place, oh, you're wrong. You know, I hope I'm the one in your dreams that haunts you. Because after this, I'm never going to let you forget. I love having power over you, controlling your every move, making you dance like a little marionette.
Thank you.
attachment. Not allowing you to see through the facade? You children, you're so naive. Setting yourselves up to the rejection that lurks in the shadows. To trust.
How do you not feel the pressure with
said you would never give up on our world, on our dreams, on me.
How can I ever trust you again? I want to wake up from this lie.
Then wake up and just throw it all away.
Do you?
As you grow older, your imagination fades. I can only live if you have imagination, and you still believe in your child, fears, and dreams.
But who are you? Why do you care?
I was the one there all those nights you cried tears of sadness because your first love broke your heart. Or when you were younger and couldn't sleep because Santa Claus was coming. Even when you used to lean over the bed to ask if I was there, I was always there. I never wanted you to go away.
No, I'm just dreaming. This is just a dream.
This is no dream, Miranda. I always knew you could grow up and live an adult life, to forget what childhood is. Imagination and hope, they were always like my monster above them. Our time's ending now. I can feel myself turning into a dog. Goodbye. Remember me.
No! Don't go. I wish I had more time.
I can't protect you. He's coming.
say that. I didn't make you. I wouldn't make you.
Don't play dumb with me, girl. Everyone makes us. We're always there. Whenever someone hurts, whenever someone cries, we're there making things worse. But you, oh, you're different. You're not like them. You seem to enjoy our company. You let us keep talking, no matter how bad it makes you feel.
Shut up. If it's me, if it's always been me, if I'm the one who's letting you keep talking, then I can make you stop.
Do you really think it's that easy? And that you can just tell us to shut up, or to go away and listen? No. If it were that easy, you would have done it long ago. The truth is, once you've made us, there is no getting rid of us. We'll be here forever!
I don't believe you.
Oh, you can push us aside for a time, shove us into the far back corners of your mind, but we always get back out. We always get back out. Look at you. You're pitiful. You're worthless.
Stop it!
No, be honest. Of all of them, you are the worst. You can't face what you created. You disgust me.
Why are you doing this? I can't live like this.
Because you never get bored. You never stand up and fight. They make us shut up. They make us go away with you. Oh, you're much too scared. So you keep on whining and crying. You're like a little insect buzzing in our ear. You never shut up. You're exactly what we like.
No. You lie. You just say that so you can stay here. The longer I'm down, the longer you get to stay. You leave when things get better, and I stand up and tell you to go. If I was that weak, I could have ended it long ago. I could have put us both out of our misery.
Then do it. Go on, what are you waiting for? It's that easy. Oh, stop. You know what that's for. For as long as you've wanted to get rid of us, a part of you knew that that was the only way. But you were too scared, so you kept on whining. Now, stop it! Get out of my head! I can't live like this! I can't take anymore! You asked for freedom. It comes with a price, so stop whining and do it! Thrust a dagger through your heart. And let your sorry soul depart!
No!
Just as I thought. You never will be strong enough.
No. This ends now. Why should I suffer from you? I'm not the one that needs to be punished. I did nothing to deserve it. It's over.
You finally understand.
Such a selfish way to live. The way you lose these wasted blues. These wasted blues. Tell me that it's nobody's fault. Nobody's fault but my own. Tell me that it's nobody's fault. Nobody's fault. Such a selfish way to lose. The way you lose these wasted blues. These wasted blues. Tell me that it's nobody's fault. Nobody's fault but my own. Tell me that it's nobody's fault. Nobody's fault. Nobody's fault, nobody's fault but my own. Tell me that it's nobody's fault, nobody's fault but my own.
Always the darkest before dawn, my sweet child. Your fitted self displayed inside a grotesque fallacy. All your dreams are a lie. One last time. Attempt to recover from your fear of commitment, fear of trust, and fear of attachment. We must take our leave, but we'll dream of you again sometime soon. Till then, it's nobody's fault. This must end.
choices, girl. They're one and the same. I'm a sign so late to. I'm so late to save you from
I'm sorry. sister, this is a letter for you. It seems you've opened up your heart again. We've journeyed to where we've never been, far from our roller coaster Friday nights to our Southern Park spot. What you don't say scars us all, but I'm not mad. It's not your fault. In fact, it's nobody's fault. Your only fault is your perfect heart in an imperfect world. I remember a brisk March day, made with snowmans and angels, and we were not cold, only our red and tinted faces dressing ourselves up, looking for a bluer sky. I know I haven't been around much, especially in your everyday life, but that doesn't mean that I don't think about you and want you to be happy. I hate it when we can't share things. I really try to understand because I want you to wake up from this painful memory. Find what makes you smile, what makes you laugh, and helps you to feel again. I think we all have taken a step away from happiness and peace. Peace from indecision, peace from heartache, peace like willows in the wind. Your beauty, your innocence, your sweetest voice will carry you through. After all, it can't rain all the time. Waiting for the sun, your big sis.